Before we get started today, I absolutely must insist that nothing that I say in the upcoming video that you take as a suggestion or recommendation for a certain type of investment. If you plan to make investment decisions, you need to make those based on your own opinion, your own facts, and you should consult a financial advisor. At least that's what the legal department told me to say. Hi guys, thanks so much for joining me. Having a little bit of fun there in the beginning, but I really do mean that you need to make your own decisions. But I wanted to share some information with you about whether or not gold is a good investment. And the reason I'm sharing this with you is because, well, I decided to look it up myself. Over the past few years, I've been diversifying our family's investment portfolio, and I've kind of gone through the normal steps of securing us or insuring us through all kinds of products like term life, whole life, disability, and getting all of our insurance products in place. And then I started doing some investing outside of the normal 401k and things like that. I started to test the waters with stock investing of my own, not necessarily day trading, but buying stocks for a period of time, holding on to them as they grow and then selling them. I did that originally with what you might call a penny stock, which is just a stock whose per share price is less than $5. Did really good there and had some really awesome returns north of 300% and still hold some of those penny stocks. And then I started to want to diversify more and looking at various other places to put our money, like real estate and other things. And one of the things I've been thinking about, especially as I think about the potential of a recession here in the near future, is where gold plays a role in our investment portfolio. So I started to research that. What really got me kicked off was I was listening to the Tim Ferriss show, his podcast, and he had a gentleman on there named Peter Malouk. And Peter runs one of the largest, if not the largest, wealth fund management companies in the United States. And one of the early questions Tim asked Peter was about gold and his thoughts on it. Now, I'm not going to spoil that for you because it's a great podcast episode. I want you to head on over there and listen to it yourself. Take in the information and learn on your own. But the things that Peter shared really got me thinking about gold. So I decided to go off and do my own research on it. I wrote a short white paper on that. You can find it over on my blog, and I'll share that link below. But today I want to recap those findings, and I am going to tell you I'm going to cheat a little bit. I've got a list here below me of the things to mention because the research was fairly substantial. It wasn't exhaustive. I didn't go all the way in because I frankly just didn't have time to do that. But I wanted to learn enough to make an educated decision about if gold is a good investment. Here's what I found out. So first I want to share with you the history of gold. So as far as we can tell, you can go back and find gold being used all the way back in 3000 BC. They believed the Egyptians were one of the first groups of people to use it. And of course, gold was used because, well, it was malleable and it was bendable, and so you could craft it into things, and of course it was attractive. It was a beautiful metal, precious metal. So the Egyptians were the first to use it. Flash forward to 700 BC, and that's the first evidence historians could find where gold was actually used or bought as a currency back and forth. There were some merchants that did that. That was back when they were able to take a metal called electrum, I believe it was called, which is a combination of silver and gold. And they were able to sort of pull the gold out of that and use it around 400 BC. So we have this evolution of using it as a beautiful thing. I imagine it was probably traded. Gold was all the way back with the Egyptians. But then merchants start using gold as coins and buying those coins and used in their trade. Flash forward even more, it goes through this whole, you know, period of being used for all these variety of purposes and different coins made and things like that. And then around the time of the World Wars, So the gold rush in California is one of the things, at least here in the United States, that increased the popularity of gold. So everyone was rushing out to California. Large stores of gold were found, and it became even more popular and more commonplace. So then flash forward to the World Wars. Yeah, the First World War and the Second World War. And during that period from about the 1800s until around the middle, 1900s, gold was used. It was called the gold standard. So the value of currencies, that paper currencies that were being printed by various countries, was being tied to gold. Well, then the World Wars happened. Having trouble speaking today. The World Wars did happen. And along the way, a lot of the countries that were involved in the World Wars needed to produce or print more money, and they didn't have enough gold to to attach value to that paper money. So actually, a wide variety of countries decided to decouple the value of their paper currency from gold, and they sort of broke away from that gold standard. And then you had inflation go up because countries reporting were printing more paper currency than their gold that they had in store could support in terms of value. So you have this whole decoupling of the thing. Now, gold just happens to have really changed in value about the time that some of those things happened. So in 2010, we have the highest record of a per ounce value of gold, around $1,895. If you go all the way back to 1970, right after most countries had done that decoupling of the from the gold standard with their paper currency, in 1970, we're looking at a per ounce value of roughly $35. Now, guys, from 40 years, 1970 to 2010, we go from $35 per ounce all the way up to $1,895. That's a 5,021% increase in gold over those 40 years. And if you look at the graph that's in my white paper, you'll actually see right about the time that decoupling becomes a normal thing, the countries break away from tying their paper currency to gold, all of a sudden the value of gold, not every year, but for the most part, starts to go up. People see more value in it. In that happening. So that's a little bit on the history of gold, a little bit on the value of gold. So now let's talk about whether or not gold should be considered a good investment. So I found an article where USA Today did a comparison. Now this only goes back from 2009 till 2018, so about a 10-year period. Certainly if you wanted to dig deeper, you could go all the way back to compare the return on these investments. But for sake of today, 2009 till 2018, USA Today did a report. They took a $100,000 investment, assumed you put it in four different categories, and here's the returns they got. So stocks during that time, large cap, bigger company stocks, if you took $100,000 in 2009 and invested it, by 2018, it would have been worth $425,000. That's a 325% increase if my calculations are correct. So, how did gold do? Well, gold, during that same period of time, $100,000 invested in it, would have turned into $143,000. Not bad, a 43% return, but that's almost eight times lower than what stocks would have done. How about two other categories? What about real estate? I've been looking at real estate, and I actually do some investing in real estate, and I've talked about how I do that. Real estate during that time frame would have been would have gone from $100,000 to $119,000 during that period. So about a 12% return. So not doing as good as gold. That's residential, by the way, not commercial real estate. Not doing as good as gold, but doing pretty well. Most people would take a 12% return. And then finally, European stocks. This one intrigued me. $100,000 invested over that time would have turned into $235,000 or 135% return. So if I rank those, large cap stocks did the best, followed by European stocks, then gold, then real estate over that time frame. So that just gives you an idea. Now, I also want to talk about, I put the question out before I did my research to my friends and contacts and asked what types of things that you would like to learn while I'm in the middle of doing this research. And one of my good friends, Carl Hughes, asked, what's the best way for a beginner to buy gold? And so I researched that. Wikipedia actually has a pretty good synopsis of this. They actually go into the different ways to buy it and some of the best recommendations. I'm not going to make those myself. Go read that article. They talk about, you know, if you're going to buy physical gold, right, there's two different ways. You can buy physical gold or you can just invest in gold. If you're going to buy physical gold, they rank some of the companies that have the best, better business bureau rankings, that so therefore you can assume you can trust these companies. If you're going to buy gold physically, you do it typically through bars or gold coins. A lot of people think about having gold because, for me, because gold is a tangible thing that comes out of our earth, I personally like the idea of handling it, of having it on hand. I'm smiling a little bit because I'm thinking about some of the preppers that I don't necessarily know, but I see talk. They seem to like the idea of owning gold because of, you know, if the world goes crazy and we have an economic disaster, they'll have gold on hand and they'll be able to barter with that and trade it for various goods, water, food, those types of things. That's probably true, but one of the things I want you to think about, if that's why you're thinking about buying some physical gold, is how hard is it to actually break off pieces of that, right? So let's assume that you have gold coins, or really even larger, a gold bar. How are you going to shave off parts of that to trade for some water or something like that, right? So it's not exactly going to work out the way a lot of people think. Maybe if your gold coins are smaller and you can, sort of parse those out, that might work. But I don't suggest buying physical gold just because you think the economy is going to go crazy and the world's going to fall apart and you want to have it to barter. There's probably other things that you could barter with at that time. So you can buy physical gold, coins, and bars. If you're going to do that, you better have a place to store it. You might use your bank's safe deposit box, but that sort of takes out the idea of you physically having your hands on it. So you may have a safe in your house or something like that you want to put it in. The thing to think about with physical gold is you got to worry about the security of it, where you're going to keep it. Now, you can also buy gold as an investment and have somebody else handle it. So a couple of ways to do that is you can buy gold certificates. You could buy shares in a mining company that mines gold and other precious metals. You can also invest in gold through ETFs, exchange traded funds, which work a lot like a mutual fund, but that those shares can be traded. So there's a variety of ways to do it. At the end of the day, what it comes down to with gold is, why do you want it? Do you want to have your hands on it like I would? Does it help diversify your portfolio, which I do believe gold does. And so at the end of the day, what I'm going to do is probably invest in some gold. I'll probably buy some physical gold coins, have them somewhere here in a safe nearby, those types of things. So I'll probably do that. But I'm not doing it as a prepper. I'm not doing it because of a doomsday scenarios. I'm doing it to diversify our portfolio, to sort of hedge against recessions and things like that. I'll probably buy physical coins. Again, if you're going to do these types of things, I absolutely must insist that you research this yourself, make your own investment decisions. But I wanted to share this with you because I thought it was valuable information. I know it certainly helped me a lot. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.